Want to live at Disney World? Let's make it a Realty reality. Everything from Dr. Phillips to Davenport, Claremont to Kissimmee, Winter Garden or Windermere, and Disney's own Celebration and Golden Oak. I'm Realtor Victor Nawrocki, and this is Disney at Your Doorstep. Beautiful, beautiful. Okay, so I am here with one of my customers who purchased a home in Windermere, and I had met him online and been showing him some properties during his first visit, and later on we found a property that was perfect for him, and I'm going to introduce you now to Joe. Hey, Joe.
Hi, Victor. How are you?
Great, great. So, I was telling them that you had found a property that was, you know, perfect for you. But walk us through quickly what your experience was finding that home.
Well, the beginning, when we first started to really look, we actually looked at new builds. So when we came down to visit you, we spent, you know, a few days with you traveling around looking at all the builders and trying to figure out where we wanted to go, since we wanted to be right next to Disney.
And you were interested in having a home with a pool.
Oh, absolutely. We definitely needed the pool. And then, you know, so talking with the builders, you know, it seemed that our best option in the end was to start looking for resale. But we didn't decide that right away. I would say, you know, we spent still quite a few months dealing with the new builders and speaking with them after the visits and discussing different options with them, and then looking into some resales that started to catch our eye. And they happened to be newer resales.
Yeah. Now, one of the things that I find is, and I think we both found it together too, was that sometimes when you want a pool, you don't really have to pay that much extra for it.
No.
Because there's not a lot of people like you that want the pool. So we got a house that was competitively priced with new construction without a pool. So we got you, I think you got a really good opportunity there that you wouldn't have necessarily gotten if you had not wanted a pool or something. Right. So
right. Definitely, you have to weigh that option out. And that was a serious option for us to really consider. And it's definitely one of the big considerations you really need to make before coming down. Because to do it afterwards is really could be a potential nightmare for you. And if you're spending all this time and energy to find your dream home, make it your dream home, because you have one shot for your dream home.
Yeah. So we decided not on new construction, but to find a resale, because the cost of putting in a new pool was prohibitive. Plus, you know, all the option choices and ended up increasing the price.
Sure. And even though we expected to possibly go a little above what our planned budget was, it was going to drive it a little bit more than what we really intended on it really being. So luckily, we have found in Windermere the newer construction homes that were, you know, at least in 2015. So has all the new construction that, you know, we wanted to keep with look if we were going to go with the resale, with the better windows and insulation and, you know, all the extras that they kind of, you know, switched on, which you actually told us about when we first started looking.
Yeah. One of the things that I liked about your home was actually a detriment to selling it, which meant you got a better price for it. And reason why it didn't sell was it did need some cosmetic work, but not that much.
No, it was the cosmetic work we fixed in a weekend when we moved in. It literally took us, you know, the weekend that we moved here, we signed the house that weekend. You know, it took us to fix the little bit of problems.
And that probably
enormous amounts of money.
That probably took about 5% off the cost of the home.
Yep.
And made them more eager to sell, but they weren't willing to do any work. And it wasn't that much.
Which was lucky for us.
Exactly.
It was so stubborn.
Exactly. So now the topic of this presentation is finding the best realtor in Windermere. What led you to me?
Watching your videos, we came across you online a few years ago, streaming.
Yep.
So that kind of, you know, caught our eye, and then realized on top of everything, you really knew what you seemed to be talking about. And we looked into the research and we looked into the company and we saw that, you know, you were an established person. You weren't someone who just popped up and started trying to, you know, sell properties overnight.
Yeah. Well, I hope
and you had real knowledge and honest opinions of the area, and you knew what was developing in the area. So it really enabled us to, as much as we thought we knew the area, visiting here for 15 years, you don't know the area until you drive around. And that was one of the great things too, was having you drive us through the areas to actually see what was around.
Well, that is a good point you bring up, because when people stay on property or off property, they're going to be in the more tourist area. And honestly, that might be good for a vacation, but not good for long-term residents. So they're not noticing that if you go north or west, you get these very residential bedroom communities that are very quiet, have features that you've been looking for, but you don't see them because you're in a hotel.
Right. And you stay wrapped up in that bubble. And we even rented cars and we were still blind to the whole thing. It wasn't only until the last year or so when we really got serious, where we would dedicate, you know, our first week of a 2 week vacation with you, or just being in the area and really just visiting and seeing what was there.
Well, I remember one night you came and met me at a house and where I was videotaping the fireworks from that house.
Yes.
And for the first month you were at your house, you could see fireworks from your front porch.
Yes, it was beautiful. It was, you know, sit on the porch at night and just watch them go off.
It'll be back. It'll be back.
It'll be back.
So, what did you discover in the experience? Was there anything that surprised you other than what we discussed?
Yeah, I think like what you were saying, how much was to offer outside the little bubble, because even though we were very into Disney, realistically, you're not spending every day there and you do have to live a life. And seeing the outside, the outer perimeter of everything really helped and really gained to us really deciding on where to go. Seeing the actual school and seeing the proximity to everything, that was a bonus.
Well, yeah, you got a really nice location because you're looking upon conservation area. But if you want to just take a walk to the grocery store or the Italian ice place, it's right down the street.
Right down the block. And it's wonderful, you know, coming from New York, you know, especially out on the island, we were, you know, separated from some of that stuff. And here it's a lot more convenient, friendly. It, you know, seeing everybody walk around, there's a, you know, you don't realize how much more walking you're going to do when you move down here. Along with the weather, it's just the thing to do. And everything is, if you're in the right area, like we happen to be, you can walk to the shopping if you wanted to on a nice day and really enjoy being outside.
Now, do you have any recommendations? This is my last question. Any recommendations for buyers moving to Florida?
Yeah, definitely. If you're looking to move from far away, from quite a few states away, definitely look into anything with moving, because those moving prices can really get out of hand if you're not really paying attention to what you're bringing down with you. We only brought down what we felt were our real essentials to really need. Since we were buying a new home, we kept very minimal furniture, knowing that we would just replace it. It was a time to update it and have it match, you know, the new surroundings. So it was a good opportunity to kind of purge and be able to buy new stuff at the same time.
Well, I'm finding a lot of my customers are doing that because of the you know, we're talking about over $10,000 to move a whole house of furniture.
Sure. And that's basically what we had almost ended up paying in the end. You know, moving from New York all the way down, you know, we shipped everything down here and then we put it all into a storage facility.
Yeah.
Just so that we didn't have our house loaded. So at least we could do like those cosmetics that we spent the weekend, you know, doing to the house to fix it. So yeah. I definitely recommend looking into that and definitely getting down here and making some, you know, trips and take it serious. If you're really serious about moving, the last thing you want to do is come to, you know, spend all that money and invest all that time and energy and find out you're not happy. If you just went here, you know, you'd be so much happier. So, you know, even though you have to really be quick because the homes down here move fast because they just happen to move quick. So you really, it's kind of a double-edged sword. You have to move quick, but you don't want to jump too quick. Research, 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 and Google Earth is probably your next best friend other than Victor. If he does not want, if you don't want to bother him every 10 minutes of what's in the area, that's a great thing to do also because you can see, since they're building so much, they always pop up new roads, or they're always working on developing new roads or extending roads or widening roads. Or
yeah.
But the construction is faster than New York construction, so it doesn't really bother us.
Well, I'll tell you, there's like in Windermere, I only know of one new development that's coming in there. So things are slowing a bit because I'm not seeing land being cleared as like I would want to. If there was going to be new construction coming on, so I think there's going to be a lot of resales in the future. That's what we're going to be looking at. So do you have any final thoughts? And you can make them about me.
They're all going to be about you. I think the final thoughts are definitely don't hesitate. Ask Victor any question that, you know, you would want to ask your best friend if they were looking at the area. You're going to get a super honest answer. You're not going to get any kind of smoke and mirrors. He's not going to make anything sound worse or anything sound better than it really is. And that's the key to everything because, you know, when you come down to see it your first time or with him that time, it's your same expectations. Or they're even better because even though now you're seeing it with your own eyes.
Yeah. Well, I know that you had at one point you had two properties that you wanted me to show you. And I went in there with a live stream, FaceTimed you, and we did like 10 minutes in each house.
And it was wonderful because I was sitting in my office at work in New York. It was during the winter, so I think it was even snowing outside.
And we were going into the home. And I was like, how do you like this pool?
Yeah. But again, having you being able to go there and physically really look at it and not having someone, you know, because I've heard of other people in the area that, you know, they'll just send more photographs or they'll go there and just take more photos of the house or forward you something else and not really go there and touch a wall and show you and point and say, well, this right here, you know, you might want to look at when you come here. But other than that,
yeah,
you know, it was super helpful. And I've worked with a few realtors in the past and top notch all the way. I only recommend Victor. And once everyone that we recommend to come down here, we have them, you know, speak with Victor.
Thank you.
He knows, and it's not just this Disney area, it's outside the areas too. He knows the golf course areas, he knows the older home areas for 55 and above. Which was really nice for some of the older friends and that we know who may be interested. So it's not just locked down to a town or two next to Disney. It's the whole area, which was very fun.
And about a year and a half, there's a new over 55 that is so close you could almost walk to Disney World.
Wow.
It's going to be like right out. I mean, literally right outside the gates of Disney World. It's amazing.
And who else is going to know that and just willing to tell people all the time that this is coming. So
yeah, exactly. Wonderful. Well, Joe, thank you so much for participating and I appreciate it. And anybody wants to reach me, my contact information will be at the end of this show, which is right now.
Call Victor.
Making the dream of a Disney lifestyle a reality. I'm Victor Nawrocki. Contact me on Facebook at Nawrocki Realtor or my website, celebratingflorida.com. Thanks for watching Disney at your doorstep.